So every night we take a look outside the day's top stories for something we call the Out Front Outtake. And the interview you just saw with Rand Paul almost didn't happen today. Was he ducking our request? No. Was there an elaborate attempt to keep us from reporting about Benghazi? No. There was one reason, and one reason only. Prince Harry. The 28-year-old prince touched down in Washington today to kick off a six-day tour of America. He's going to promote Britain, raise money for charity, and cheer on wounded veterans in D.C., Colorado, New York, and New Jersey. His first stop in Washington today was Capitol Hill, though, which brought all sorts of logistical nightmares with it. The building had to undergo a very thorough security sweep. Seriously, people. More than a few female staffers just disappeared from their desks altogether, and interviews with our lawmakers were tough to come by. It was just very difficult to get a free camera and actually even get to the camera. I mean, the president of the United States, people, doesn't come close to causing this sort of mayhem. Look, I realize it's probably strange for us to complain about this because, and this is serious, Harry's name does raise a lot of money for charity, and it's, well, you know, it's not like he can just join a public tour group when he stops by. But a couple hundred years ago, we worked really hard to get the monarchy out of our way. So it's strange we kowtow and move heaven and earth whenever they come back. By the way, the King and Queen of Sweden were also in Washington today. But as we've said on this show before, if it's not a Prince Harry or a Prince Albert, no one seems to care.